Okay, so do you have to break the bank in order to look good on your streams? Well, today I'm going to continue on my series of super budget cameras with another one of the top sellers on Amazon's webcam list. This is the EMEET C950. It's the lowest priced EMEET camera, and it goes for about $20 at the moment on Amazon. So I'm going to see if the camera is any good. Is it worth that $20? And test everything out. Let's go. Okay, so again, this is the EMEET C950 camera. Just to do a little bit of a tour on the device, you can see that it has also, kind of like the last camera I reviewed, up and down articulation. The monitor mount is actually pretty good. The thing I like about this is the camera actually sits below the plane of the where the monitor mounts, so you get a decent amount of eye contact as you look at your screen. Then it's got a fixed cable, which I'm not a huge fan of. It's about 5 feet long, 1.6 meters. Terminates, as you might expect, to USB-A. And so what I want to do is actually see if this looks good in the default settings, and then I'll try to tune the camera. Just one word before I do that, though. This is in no way sponsored. I did pay the radical amount of $20 from my own money to buy this camera, just because all the opinions are my own. And let's see what the camera looks like by default. All right, so this is the EMEET C950, and it's on its default image and also on the included or built-in microphone. So you can see what it looks like and also hear what it sounds like with all the defaults in place. All right, so the C950 looked a little bit, I would say, undersaturated this time. The last camera I tested, I think, was a bit on the oversaturated side, so you never know what you're gonna get there. As you heard with the microphone, it actually only came out of the left channel if you're listening on stereo headphones or headset. So I'm going to be mixing mono for the parts where I'm using the microphone from the camera in the future parts of this video. But one thing that you did see a little bit is, I would say from an optics perspective, the area where my face was a bit blurrier, and I'd say the background actually came in better focus as a fixed focus camera. So let's see what we can do to get the image better. We're not gonna be able to fix the optics of the camera because it is fixed focus, but let's see what we can do. Okay, so this is the EMEET C950's tuned image. It's a little bit desaturated, I think, but it's pretty close. Not a lot of dynamic range, again, because there aren't many shadows in terms of any gradients that you can see in the image. Still a little bit noisy. This is the default microphone. Now let's have a look at some of the software settings that I set. First, using EMEET LINK, then Windows settings for the camera. Okay, so one thing I did notice with the EMEET C950, I did try to download the EMEET LINK software. Then I opened it and tried to control the camera. When I do that, none of the settings are exposed except for flipping the camera. So let me try to reboot and see if that actually corrects any of those conditions, because otherwise the software doesn't do much, but Windows settings will do four different settings for this camera. All right, so I rebooted the system just to see if any of the other camera controls would appear for the EMEET, and nothing did. So I would say, for two reasons. One, the application is set to elevate to administrator upon launch, which is a really, I would say, hacky kind of fix back in the pre-Windows Vista days, where you try to run elevated as highest for an application just so you get all the rights on the system. That's dangerous, so I would say don't load it for the C950 because of that reason. Otherwise, I'd also say don't load it because these different settings to actually adjust the image of the camera. The only thing you can do with the software is flip the image horizontally or vertically. Okay, so here I've come up with different settings for this camera. Again, not using the EMEET LINK software, but using Windows settings. So I've got brightness at 31, contrast at 63, sharpness at 32. Again, that's because I want to try to get rid of some of the background noise. And the camera wasn't, you know, very sharp anyway, but even though it's kind of counterintuitive, you do want to take the sharpness down sometimes when the image is quite noisy. And the saturation I turned down to 48, which is almost its default of 50, but because I turned the contrast up, that basically kind of skewed the saturation a little bit and made it a bit brighter. So adjusting the saturation down was only a little bit necessary, whereas if I kept bright or contrast where it was by default, I would have had to go a bit further down on saturation. All right, so the EMEET C950, not a lot that you can do with the EMEET LINK software. I did get it tuned in a little bit. It ended up getting to be a nicer image in terms of color balance and those things. The mix to mono was a good trick in case you're using OBS or streaming. that's something that you're going to want to think about and do. I think for a Teams meeting or a Zoom meeting, it's probably going to compensate for that. You're probably getting a mono feed into those types of apps anyway. The one thing I didn't like about this was the fact that the EMEET software did nothing except for flip the image. The other thing was the EMEET software wanted to have elevation when I just ran the software. It didn't even let me run it as a standard user, which is a bad thing because that means that the app can actually perform different system changes. So based on that, I would say one, there weren't any settings that you couldn't do in the Windows 11 settings anyway, so it didn't give you any extra value. And two, you don't want a rogue application that's running at admin level privilege the entire time while you're using the camera, because you never know what's happening with that application or if it's safe. So don't download and install the EMEET LINK app if you can avoid it. And with this camera, you definitely can avoid it because you can do all those things and those setting changes through the Windows app. There's no additional value there. So I would say it's a good value for $20, even though it's not the best value for $20. So hopefully if you like this review and got value from it, give me a like. Otherwise, subscribe to my channel for more reviews like this. I do like to buy webcams and try them out. And as always, thank you so much for watching.